Welcome to lockdown vlog number 24. Today is another beautiful day in Rotterdam. No rain. In fact, we are having too little rain for the last few weeks, so that is starting to become a problem. But anyways, let's play some music. Let's make some coffee. Okay, well, you couldn't miss that one. That was, of course, Billie Holiday. And I thought solitude was fitting for these days. For today, there's one thing I like to show you, and there's one question of my subscribers that I would like to answer together with you guys. First of all, this was Billie Holiday, and this came from this wonderful booklet that I got as a present from a friend a few years ago. I helped him set up his audio system, and I want to show you this this box, because this is a very wonderful, beautiful box. Now, this card is not part of it, but this is his thank you card, and actually what he writes is, "Thank you for learning me how to listen again." So this is something that I am going to keep with it. This was the slip from the outside, telling you from all the CDs in here what numbers there are on the CDs. And it has this nice little way of packaging all the CDs, which is, of course, if I put this aside, a reminder to, this is something I have, which is an old booklet for to put your 78s in there. This one is empty now, but there was over here a space so you could write down what albums you had in here. And then, of course, you had all this lovely envelopes that you could put your 78s in. I have another one over here, which is a nice edition from Beethoven. And this one has been filled up with all the wonderful records that should be there. And then, of course, you had over here the part where it wrote, where they told you what songs are in here, something about the music and stuff like that. And if you look at this, they try to mimic it a little bit. There is, of course, CDs now in here, And at the back, they did tell you, they do tell you what songs are on there. And number 7, that is missing now, because that's what you just heard. And over here at number 6, you see the song Solitude. So to show you a little bit more about this wonderful edition, it has this sleeve in there with all kind of people like Tony Bennett, Elvis Costello, Marianne Faithfull, Jimmy Scott, B.B. King, all kind of people telling something about their experience with Billie Holiday. And then you have this wonderful, really, well, let me change hands, this wonderful booklet. This is really very, very thick booklet with very expensive, beautiful paper. Let me just try to do this with one hand. So song index, discography. In this book, which has, well, a lot of pictures, a lot of text, tells you all about all her records, and it tells you for every disc what songs are on there and what everybody is playing. But here at the end, let me go a little bit further, somebody, in this case, whoops, John Hammond, I don't know if it did focus over there, but he, over the course of multiple pages, tells you for every song on this extensive edition a little bit about the song and his experience with that song. So this is a very comprehensive, very nice edition of the wonderful Billie Holiday. And that is what I wanted to show you for today. So that's what I wanted to share with you from my own collection. And yesterday, somebody, maybe even it was this morning, somebody wrote me a comment on vlog number 23. And what I want to do is run through this comment with you. And while I'm doing that, I'll be panning around a little bit. But there's the reason that I wanted to do it this way is so I don't have to write down everything that I want to tell him. And there's a few interesting things in there and questions, and one request that I could use your help with. So let's start. He starts with, maybe this is a silly question. Well, of course, there are no silly questions. In fact, if you don't ask questions, you never learn anything. So this is not a silly question. But do you have a suggestion on how to make a 128 or 192 kbps, kilobytes per second files, for lack of a better word, he says. Well, you can call these things MP3s because probably that's what they are. So do you have a suggestion on how to make MP3 files palatable for playback on a hi-fi system? Well, one of the first questions, of course, I want to ask is, why do you have 128 kilobyte per second MP3 files? I'm guessing, and also if I look at the avatar of this guy, I'm guessing he is a musician, and this may be old recordings that he made himself and he wants to play them, but maybe it's something else. But do you have a way to make this listenable on a hi-fi system? Now, I must say, when I'm playing the blues sounds, I told you about this last week, and when I play Spotify, which is of course MP3, this sounds pretty good. I think one of the tricks is to have a DA converter that is very friendly towards towards that kind of low bitrates files. And this is where I want to ask you guys, because I'm not playing those low bit files. I used to, of course, but nowadays I don't have any of those anymore. And so I'm not up to speed on today's things that could help playing that. I just know that playing MP3s with a low bitrate on my system I think I get the most out of what is possible from Spotify. But if you guys have any idea about making the best out of low bitrate MP3 files, I would like you to either comment in lockdown vlog number 23 or just in today's vlog number 24. So he is not, and then he continues, I'm not interested in paying for a service, but I'm interested in adding some streaming content like Pandora or YouTube. Now, one thing that I want to make on my own title is, please guys, we have to start paying for music again or we'll be in trouble in the long run. So I understand that people would like to do this for free and download illegal music. I'm paying for Spotify and I'm paying for Tidal. And I know this may be too much for you to have this on a monthly basis, to have those expenses. I don't know, but we have to start paying for our music again. Otherwise, I don't know where we will end up, but there's a lot of flack on the streaming services for not paying the artists, but I'm convinced that it's mostly the record companies that is not paying the artist and making money for themselves. So that on the side note. So he continues, while I'm not expecting a miracle, I understand garbage in is garbage out. Yes, because it's not so much MP3 or FLAC or WAV file, but also the quality of the original recording that plays a part in that. So he's correct there. Maybe you or someone has worked out an inexpensive way or component path that could make playing lower res audio files from free services worthwhile for those of us that presently exclusively use vinyl and or CD. Okay, so his question is, what is the best way to play low bitrate MP3 files? He plays CDs, he plays vinyl. I can imagine that his system may be pretty okay for playing those things. But, so my answer is, get a good DA converter. I think for me that is the trick to get the most out of the music. And if I compare my PS Audio DA converter and the DA converter in the Blue Sound is a little bit more friendly sounding. So that is something that I would be looking for, a more friendly sounding DA converter. The PS Audio is a better DA converter, much more detailed, but it's, in this case, for a low bitrate, that might not be the best way to go. So for you guys out there listening, and if you want to help this guy, what are you using at home, or what have you experienced for playing low bitrate MP3 files and still having a pleasurable experience? Okay, so that is the vlog for today. One last thing that I need to say. Two last things. One, my work is starting to pick up a little bit again after all these weeks with doing nothing. I every now and then have to start doing some work again, which is okay, but it may be if I am missing a day of vlogs, I'm trying not to, but if I'm missing a day, don't worry. It's just that work is taking my time. And the other thing is that this week, I'm not sure, tomorrow, the day after tomorrow, I will have a video from a system from one of you, from one of my subscribers. I asked him to video his equipment. I made a movie of it, and that is what I'm going to put on YouTube somewhere this week. So stay tuned if you are interested in that. And that's all for today. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. Please try to help this guy with his question, and I'll see you tomorrow.